Hello, I'm here for round one with Mono Blue, and luckily I won the roll. Okay, so a common theme with Mono Blue is that most of your hands won't be perfect, and you're just gonna have to keep needing to draw either lands or a creature to fill out your curve. You can't be too particular with the hands you mulligan. A deck based on synergy is gonna need a lot of cards rather than a few high quality cards. Right, luckily we did draw a land, so we'll be able to play either Night Vale or Thassa on turn three and follow that up with the very powerful four drops. All right, opponent had a lot of cards, Burning Trees and a Sylvan Carrington. I'm gonna play Night Vale so that I can block the Burning Trees and so that I'll be able to attack next turn. Next turn, I can play Cloudfin and Thassa, or maybe a Master. Likely, it'll be the Cloudfin and the Thassa. All right, Pelucranos is going to be difficult to beat. The opponent has currently seven devotion, so eight mana. So can monstrous for three at least, maybe four. So that could be a little bit of a problem. If I really wanted to, I could domesticate a Burning Tree Emissary to take away some of the mana. I might end up doing that. Okay, Voyaging Satyr doesn't do me too much good. Okay, so I'm definitely not casting a Master of Waves into Pelucranos, that's out of the question. If I play Cloudfin and Thassa, then my opponent can kill Night Vale, and that leaves me in not a great position where I'll only have two devotion. So I think, even though it doesn't progress my board very much, I'm just going to domesticate a Burning Tree Emissary to remove some of my opponent's devotion. Okay, my opponent has a Courser and another Burning Tree, so next turn, there could be a lot of mana, but I also get to take away the Burning Tree if my Night Vale lives. Looks like that might not be the case. Looks like my opponent played another Nykthos to generate 7 mana. And as Pelucranosing for 3, it'll probably kill my Night Vale if I had to guess. So it's really not good for me. I'm gonna be taking a lot of damage this turn. But at least in the future, I'll have a Master Waves that maybe won't die. Okay. Cloudfin was not a great draw. I think, just in order to not die, I'm going to need to play a Master of Waves to have blockers for next turn. And I think it's pretty unlikely that I win this game, but if my opponent doesn't draw too much more gas, I could maybe win. But the opponent just had such a great start of double Burning Tree and a Caryatid and double Nykthos as well. Okay, here's a Nissa, and the lands are colorless, so Master Waves does not have protection from the land. So it's quite an aggressive play. Yeah, I'll just concede and move on to the next game. You know, with a Garrick on top, I don't think I was particularly plausible to win that game. Okay, so the main card that I want to have an answer to in this matchup is Pelucranos. So I'm going to board in Rapid Hybridization, and I suppose Dissolves as well. Dissolve is traditionally good against a ramp deck. And Domestication is not actually very good, even though my opponent's playing a creature deck. I don't want to pay 4 mana to take a Voyaging Satyr. And I think that I can cut a Biden of both the Biden of Thassa's as well, because I'm bringing in Dissolve. All right, I'll be back for game 2.